Sorry, I don't. If I got my cigar and I got some nice music,
yep.
I can drive. I just stop, put gas, and keep going.
Oh, I don't. I don't like driving at night anymore.
We'll
drive.
To be honest with you, I have to use glasses now, so I don't like to. But if I have to, I don't have a problem with it.
Well, we didn't leave until Sunday afternoon, like 1 o'clock. So we drove to Richmond, stayed overnight, and the next night we drove to
Jacksonville.
Jacksonville to here. So we got a good night's sleep and relaxed.
Yeah, and it was a half a day the first day and a half a day the last day. So it's basically 2 days driving to do it.
What do you drive, diesel or gasoline?
No, gas. Gas.
We have a Hyundai Santa Fe SUV.
SUV, well, real nice.
And it is, yeah. I have to put, I lease it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 12,000 miles a year. I've had it a couple weeks over a year, and I'm only at 10,000 miles, so I might as well use it.
Well, you're driving.
And it's, yeah, it has a lot of room, and I think it's pretty comfortable. Gas mileage is pretty
good. How are you gonna bring everything down in the truck?
We're not gonna bring much.
Stuff down. We went shopping.
We've been buying furniture and we've been buying
here.
Yep. Yeah.
And what are you gonna do with your tools and all that? You gonna get rid of that over there?
Mm-hmm. It'll go.
We'll have an auction. That's the easiest way to do it.
No guns? No, you don't have no guns for action?
Oh yeah, we have guns.
I have. See, we have two
shotguns.
He has a shotgun. I have a shotgun. My rifle. Your rifle.
What kind of rifle?
30-06.
30-06. Mine's a 30.
Has a
30-30. Like this?
No.
Like this or clip?
Bolt.
Bolt action.
Okay, boom. One at a time.
That's right.
You don't have no.
No, I don't have any lever actions.
How do you call that? Lever action?
Yeah, that's what they're called.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like they use in the Wild West days.
So you use those rifle to hunt then?
We used to.
I used to hunt too. Too much work.
Well, she likes the wildlife too much.
You do?
I don't like the deer too much. They eat all my plants.
We have so many deer.
They do. Everything. Stuff they never ate. All of a sudden they're eating.
And you don't shoot them?
Well,
I don't want to get in trouble.
The neighbors are going to shoot them. Well, during the season.
Yeah.
And then we have the squirrels come down out of the woods and raid the bird feeders. She shoots them. She goes on the upstairs bedroom window and shoots them.
With what? What do you shoot them with?
22.
22.
It's Annie Oakley.
And you hit them? You hit them?
Yeah, yeah. I hit them.
Yeah, well, how many did you kill last year?
64. 64, 70 something.
And what do they do? They,
huh?
You take them up in the
weekend. In the woods and throw them, and guess what? The next morning they're gone.
Yeah, but what do they eat?
What do they eat?
You shoot them because what do they do to you?
They're eating all the money we spend to feed the birds.
That's what they eat, huh?
Yeah.
Sunflower seeds.
They tear apart the bird.
They rip
feeders.
Apart the bird feeders too.
Wow.
Little buggers.
So you shoot them with a 22.
Yeah.
18 bullets. 18 shots.
One.
It's a single shot.
It's a single shot.
It's an over and under. It's a 410 22.
410 shot and a 22 over. I don't use the 410.
So you shoot a pow, pow, pow.
No, just once.
Poof, and then you go again.
Yeah. If I have to. Usually I don't have to.
They all run?
The other ones that I wasn't aiming at, yeah.
But then they come right back.
They do come right back. They're stupid.
You're gonna feel like that? You're gonna feel like going out there?
I don't want to bring them down here.
You gotta have something here.
Yeah. Well, I have a 22 revolver.
Oh, okay.
Is that thing recording sound too?
Everything. So are you talking something illegal?
That's not good.
Uh-oh.
You better stop. I'm doing a streaming live.
You are?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
For real.
For real.
Yeah, he's doing this.
So they get, you can hear everything I'm saying.
He's doing that because
I think I better be quiet.
We're doing a promenade for a guy. So we want him to see, you know, how we're doing.
Oh, okay. We're sitting here talking and all of a sudden I happen to think.
Mm-hmm. No, but they don't care about things. It doesn't cash up while we're talking that way. They pretty much just for that.
There's presses. Is that how you make your box press?
Yeah. What do you think about Trump, man? Donald Trump. Yesterday, I was laughing because I was watching everything that he said in Alabama. He was in Alabama. That guy is crazy.
Do you think?
But I tell you, he's a great businessman. If he were to be in the, he can negotiate.
Yes, he can.
Well, he's crazy. He tells people to shut up.
He's making the whole thing interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You
know? And that's people are paying attention.
He's probably giving all these other guys a real pain in the ass.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, I like it.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see yesterday when he took his cap off and ran his hands through his hair and said...
Of course, I saw it.
That was funny.
I tell you, this I don't think that he's talking. He makes a lot of sense. And I'll tell you, neither Obama and a lot of presidents, they're not business people.
Nope.
So if you're not a business people, how can you negotiate nothing? The guy, you cannot take that away from him. The guy's a businessman.
Yep.
He knows how to deal. He knows how to negotiate. You cannot take away that from the guy.
Nope. I agree with you.
He can negotiate. He can. He was talking about Obama. Insurance, you know, Medicare.
Yeah, Obamacare.
Yeah. That sucks.
Yeah, I know. I don't think I've ever heard of one person that has tried to get it or has it that says it's worth anything. Oh,
this is like communists.
Yeah.
You got it, or you get in trouble. That sounds like a Cuban, like a Cuban country.
You're right.
A Cuban government.
No, that's the thing. I didn't read it when it first came out. I don't understand all of it, but I'm thinking, what in the heck are you talking about? The people don't have insurance because they can't afford to get insurance. Now you're going to say they have to have it, and if they don't have it, you're going to fine them. If they don't have money to start with, how in the heck are they going to pay a fine? Stupid.
Speaking stupid is that? It's like my country, Cuba.
Uh-huh.
Or you do, or you're in trouble.
Yeah.
There's only two options. So So my company that I used to work, they gave me an insurance because now the insurance is mandatory. So when they gave me the insurance, say, listen, I don't need an insurance because I don't go to the doctor, never. I'm an Iron Man. So I don't want insurance. No, but you have to take it because the Obamacare, you don't take it. But that's my problem, not your problem.
That's right.
That's my problem.
They try to rule your life.
If they find me, it's my problem. No, you have to take it. Well, I have to take the insurance from the company. You know how much I pay for the freaking insurance? $117 every 2 weeks.
Really?
Wow. I say, what? Let me call Obamacare. So I call Obamacare, and they give me insurance for $50 a month.
Really?
Yeah, the government.
Yeah, but the premium is.
Yeah, no, but the government give me like $250 in credit. So my real insurance is like $300 a month, but I only pay $50. I pay the $50 first time. They send me the card, they send me everything. I go to my company and say, hey, I got Obamacare. I want you to take that shit on me.
Yeah.
2 days later, I call Obamacare and say, I don't want your insurance.
Right.
Take it back.
Right.
I don't need insurance. I don't have to waste $140 every 2 weeks or $50 a month for something that I don't use it.
Not only that, when you need to use it, it's like me. The other day, you know, this and that, gotta pay over $800 out of my pocket.
Out of the pocket, right? What good is it?
Yeah, and the co-payment and this and that, you pay another $100.
I went to see the urologist. They did that test, the prostate, They did some check my kidney, check this, take blood for this, take blood for that. Next thing you know, boom, everything is fine. Go home. Gotta pay $100. When I went to get the result, $140.
Get out.
$140 to the guy to tell me, well, your kidneys, your liver, your come on, that's part of the thing. It's crazy.
Yeah. I'm gonna walk over and get a pack of cigarettes at the gas station here. Except I'm not taking this.
Have a cigar.
I can, but I need to have a cigarette. You don't have cigarettes anymore,
no.
Do you? I didn't think so. Here you go. Watch it.
The cigarettes are bad for your health anyway.
Huh?
These are better for you than a cigarette.
Yeah, the difference is this is all natural. And just on the paper of the cigarette, you have 1,000 chemicals.
That's right.
And really bad for you.
Plus, whatever they mix in the tobacco.
Yeah. So, in this cigar, it's all natural.
How long have you been growing cigars?
Oh, for about 20 years.
20 years?
Yeah.
Wow. Now, were you born in Cuba? Is that where you learned it?
I learned in Cuba, yeah.
Hi.
How you doing,
brother? Good morning. I'm in Greenwich.
Sorry. What's up, man?
The U.S. Cuban relations now. So
that's finishing the same shit. That's finishing the same thing that we have before.
Because it's your brand, right?
I don't know too much about politics and stuff like that, but the Cuban government won something that the United States never gonna give it, the Guantanamo Bay.
Uh-huh. Well, they're gonna give Guantanamo Bay when the Cuban give back to this country, Miami.
Listen, the Guantanamo Bay, the United States has a lot of bases everywhere.
We took Miami from this
but
time.
The Guantanamo Bay,
hey, if you don't speak Spanish, buddy,
the most Miami, important base that they have. Well, it's the Caribbean view.
Of course not. How are they going to get
them? You know what I mean? So they can see everything from there. They can check everything from there. They give away Panama.
Yeah.
The kind of Panama. The
economy going to do better in Cuba.
Panama, they only give it to the United States to spend more money.
A lot of people want to see Cuba.
So they give it away. But the Guantanamo Bay,
yeah, but not the Cuba. The Cuba
no.
Because they're going to take you to tourist place. They're not going to take you to see the Rio McCoy.
But you can go.
They're not going to have
it. I can go.
I'm talking about if you go visit the country, you can go on your own to the Rio McCoy, right? No.
You're going to get killed. You're going to get killed. You can go just like that.
Maybe. Who's going to kill you?
My friend, the Cuban. What do you think? Cuba, I cannot go, if he goes to my neighborhood, he'll be from Cuba. Now, like, Cuba is different.
No, for the Cuba, for the Cuban government, it's really good. But they take more money. Now you can go to Cuba without any
clothes. They didn't take your shoes.
But for the people in here, it's not a good business. Like, for example, my girlfriend. She spent $10 to go to Cuba.
Huh?
With those $10, she talking for about...
But you gotta be careful.
Maybe 12 minutes.
Of course.
$10, 12 minutes to talk to Cuba. With the same money, when she finished with Cuba, she got like left over like 80 cents, probably dollar. She called her sister in Italy.
The Russian, they wanted to go back to Cuba.
Or with the 80 cents, she can talk to Italy for about 10 minutes.
So the army said, hey, well, it's better off for us to go than to have the Russian
for 80 cents.
For 80 cents. So,
he made a good call.
The people who own this business in the United States, they don't want change.
The question is good. But he made it because the Americans.
It's like, you go to your Western Union right now. And you can send $5,000, I think $1,000 for $8.
If they lift the embargo, it's going to be a government thing.
You know how much could you send $100 to Cuba?
How much?
No.
$12.
No.
If Obama stays.
So the people from Western Union, they don't want change.
Listen. You gotta watch, because there's a lot of bad, the way that they give them. The only reason why Obama wanted to do this is because the Russians, they were in Cuba talking to the government to negotiate the debt that Cuba had with Russia in order to get the game, to be able to put a plant there so they can be watching the United States from 90 miles away. That was a
good... Gee, that sounds like something that happened 1961.
So that was a good move by Obama. Saying, hey, you don't need nothing from the Russian. Whatever you need from the Russian, we're going to give it to you. But let's not go back to 1961. Over with. Because if you don't know...
We're going to give them something.
My friend, you're not going to give them nothing. The only thing that you're going to give them, listen, first of all, now that Cuba, they want to leave Cuba, they're not going to be able to do it because there's a relationship. That's why since they've been talking about this, we got more people leaving Cuba illegally than last year. In 4 or 5 months, there's been more Cuba leaving Cuba illegally than all the Cuba that they left last year. First of all, it's gonna be a government thing. The Cuban from Cuba, my mom, my brother, my sister, they're not gonna get no benefit from that. Forget it, they're not gonna get no benefit from that.
All the money that goes to Cuba is for the government.
It's for the government, not for the Cubans.
Well, I'm not surprised at that.
It's not for the Cubans. So my mom, if I stop selling, after they do all this business, if I stop selling money to my mom, she'll die. If I stop selling money to my sister, she'll die. So nothing the Cuban, we call them el cubano de a pie, the walking Cuban, the Cuban low. Now, the people at the high level, they're going to get richer, They're going, but the Cuban, 95% of the population ain't gonna see. My friend, have you seen?
They'll still be like,
my friend, my friend, have you seen a horror movie?
Yeah.
Some guy walking into an alley and watch. That's what Cuba is. Believe me. You know that I go there.
Yeah.
Cuba is not, Cuba at this time, unless you go to tourist places, Cuba right now, in front of his house, El Flaco, and in front of my house, Cuba this time, you don't see, at this distance, you don't see nobody.
Yeah.
Very dark city, it's not like that. It's not what people think.
Cuba looked like a country after the war.
But then you're still trying to come over illegally, right?
Well, if they agree to a lot of things, then that ain't gonna stop. That's gonna stop.
Out of the tourists,
the tourist places, if they come over.
Of if course. You watch Cuba, mm-hmm. It's like after the war.
It's like the Twilight Zone.
Really?
Of course. In Cuba, you fall asleep. In Cuba, you fall asleep because you're drunk. And you are in the Malecón, Red Flaco, uh-huh. And you fall asleep in one of the bench.
Malecón is
the
like,
next day,
are you from Tampa?
No.
Malecón is like West Shore?
West Shore, Southside, yeah. With water, up. In Cuba, you go out and you fall asleep. Listen, my friend, they will take your underwear without touching your pants. You don't know.
They don't want my underwear.
No, but I'm saying that's crazy. Cuba is not like the tourists gonna go with tourist people, and the tourists you cannot do tourists in Cuba. You go tourism in Cuba, you're gone.
If you do tourism, you're okay.
By yourself, you're gonna be gone. You're gonna go with people that they're gonna take you. The guy driving the bus is gonna be from Hilo, which is like the KGB in Russia. The guy's gonna be talking to you in English. This is this and that. It's gonna be that. It's gonna take you places to eat where it's gonna be surrounded. So actually, you're gonna go to Cuba, but you're not gonna see Cuba. You're gonna see whatever they're gonna show you.
What they want you to see.
So you're gonna come back and say, what a beautiful country. First thing that's gonna happen to you when you get to Cuba and you give 100 of your American dollars, they're gonna give you 80 of their pesos. So off the bat, you're losing $20. But not only that, when you're finished and you wanna come back here because you're not planning to go no more, when you decide to give your $100, their $100, they're not gonna give you your $100 back. They're gonna give you $80 of the American dollar. So you lose 20 there.
And you lose 20 there.
The Cuban government, you almost lost.
That's interesting.
Listen, I got a friend who was communist. He was, he liked the government.
Right.
This guy, his dream, it was, we call international mission.
Right.
It's go to other countries to help the people. His dream is go in this kind of international mission because when he come back, he can buy a car from the government. That was his
dream.
Don't give you
like a gift card that because you came from a mission, if you save your money, they give you a car where you can go to dealership and buy a car. Something that me as a Cuban in Cuba, we cannot do because I didn't provide no mission for the government. So,
for God's sake.
So that was his dream. His dream come true. ¿Cómo se dice IT en inglés?
¿Eh?
IT.
¿Cómo se dice?
IT en inglés, ¿cómo se dice?
Creo que es IT.
IT, el país.
Oh, he went to Haiti.
He went to Haiti.
Oh my God.
Okay, the Cuban government say that Haiti is worse than Cuba.
Yeah.
Really worse country. He was there. When he came back, he don't like no more the government. Uh-huh. He say, he's a teacher.
Okay.
He's a teacher. He say, a regular teacher in Haiti has better life than him. in a supposed country to is better than Haiti. So he applied for something that we call Loro to come to the United States.
Yeah, you know Loro, when you win Loro here, you win money. In Cuba, when you play Loro, you win, you get the right to leave the country.
That's how they're doing it, quote, legally, huh? Mm-hmm.
So he's now, he lives now in Miami.
That that surprises me that Cuba, well, I don't know anything about Cuba because we were, Christ, it's been taboo since the 60s. Mm-hmm. I never thought that Cuba was worse than Haiti. That's unbelievable.
Well, the Cuban government says like that, but this guy say, my friend, teachers on AT who work for the public school,
yeah,
they have better life than me.
Wow.
Cuba is a big lie. Just that.
Well, you're not old enough to remember what they called the heyday in Cuba when all the casinos were there and the Americans came.
Back in the day,
was so your mom? Your mom was.
My dad.
Your dad? Was it good then? Did he talk about it?
It was as good as the American. It was the paradise of the American. The American people used to work here, save money, go for their vacation to Cuba. It was their dreams. The dream for the Americans here is to go on vacation in Cuba. Yeah.
Way back in the 50s.
In the early 50s.
Yeah.
Well, that was before Castro took over, right?
59 took Castro.
That was in the days of Batista.
Batista was the president. And I'm 48 years old. I'm 48. If God gave me another 20 years to live, I don't think I'm going to see it. That ain't going to happen. They're going to go back. They're going to go there.
So what do you have to do? I don't know this either. Okay. The only way to come here legally is to win the lottery.
Uh-huh. No, you can. I can go.
Or if you have enough to pay the government.
No. Oh. I can go there, fall in love with a girl. I'm American. I bring them here, or me as an American citizen, I can bring my family.
Okay.
But it takes time. Bring mom and dad 6 months.
To me, take me 12 years.
12 years.
Like that, it's not like easy. But not me. Let's suppose that I'm divorced. And I go to Cuba and I meet this girl that has kids. I go to the embassy with and get a visa. I get an affidavit that I'm going to support them. She'll be here in 6 months. Not even that. I don't even have to get married. I just get a fiancé visa. Be here 6 months. I want to bring my mom. It will take me 6 months.
Your mom doesn't want to leave?
No, she'd be here, but she likes to go back.
Oh.
She lives good there.
I just wonder.
I support her. Oh. I rebuilt the house 5 years ago. I went to Cuba and I rebuilt the house for her. So I fix everything. And every month I send money. So why would you my mom is 78 years old.
Yeah.
Why she wanted to go? No, my mom actually is 79 because she was born in 1936. So why she want to leave? How many years have you been living in your house?
Charlie.
Since 1961.
So you've been probably living there 53 years.
54 years. That's the same time that my mom has been living in my house. So why she want to move?
Right.
When I went that 2010, and I spent $17,000, and I fixed everything up, from bathroom to sheet to kitchen to this and that, and every month I give her money. So why she want to leave?
Yeah, she's happy where she is.
I gotta bring her back here to support.
Crazy was your niece. He sent money to her niece, and it's your niece, right? And she bring it here, and now she see the real life.
It cost me like $12,000. I brought my niece, her husband, and the son. Actually, today, finally, she's moving out of my house. I have to give them money so they can.
You have to pay her to move out. You brought paid to bring her here. Uh-huh. And now you got to pay her to get out of your house.
6 months ago. She's been working for me since day number one because she's a cigar roller. The husband doesn't want to work. She's a dirty little girl. She doesn't clean. She doesn't take care of things. You know that the dispenser for ice and water in the refrigerator?
Yeah.
The company went to replace it 5 times in less than a month. My big washer and dryer that I paid over $5,000, the washer broke. The knob for the door handle. My wife brought a picture of her cleaning the bathroom. They had a bathroom. How dirty are people in?
What's the matter with it?
They live in a third world country. She was born in a third world country.
Yeah, but that's no reason not to know not how to be clean.
But that's the way it is. What did he tell you that I'm doing cleaning? That was supposed to be her part-time job. And she and her husband said it like this. Hey, we're not going to be cleaning. That's not our thing.
That's not our thing.
But me, that I've been maintaining her since she was born, that I have provided for her son since she was born, that it cost me like $12,000 to bring them here, that I had given them, now I gave them $1,800 so they can move, and I bought a car and all that, so I can go clean. I can go clean. My wife, that she's America born like you and you, that doesn't know nothing about no third world country, she goes to clean. But we live good. So we like to live. I gave today $500 to my son to go buy clothes for going back to school. But my other son drives a brand new BMW. My other son was committed like me and went to school and met himself. He's only 24. He's in the best apartment over here. He drives a brand new BMW with no help because I didn't help him with his credit that I help him build, and the way that I raise him, right now he comes in, he drives a brand new zero mileage BMW, and he lives good. You know why? Because I taught him how to live. He has the brand new STV, $5,000. He likes the good thing. But now, how long have you known me, Flaco?
Oh, for a lot of years.
Since you know me, doesn't it my son works?
Yeah.
My son went to college, got a degree, working full-time.
Wow, that's good.
And he got a part-time also.
That's something to be proud of.
My friend, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. My son went to school. He wanted to go to Orlando for 1 year of college. I said, Ulises, I'll take care of you. Don't leave. Don't leave. He left. He said, Dad, after 6 months, this is too much for me. A lot of money, blah, 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 blah. I used to help him little by little. He finished his agreement in the apartment, and he came back home. He finished over here in the FSU. You gotta see him, good looking, good body, sharp, clean, 24 years. Drive his brand new BMW, he wanted it, and everything that he has, have him. He doesn't wear no 300, he wears 300 glasses. He wears $500 shoes, because he likes the good thing. But I told him, you like it? You gotta work for it.
You work for it and you buy it.
Only 24 years old.
That's good.
So these people, I brought them from Cuba. I spent $12,000 giving up a take, probably a little bit more. I help them, and she said she's day number one. No, we're not gonna be cleaning these too much for us.
Okay, but fine. That's the point that I was with him long time ago. My friend, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it wrong because you don't show her the real life in the USA. Because this guy, look, I don't have nothing. I like to live in the life. I don't got saving account. I don't got any shit. I like to live in the life.
His life at large. Whatever he makes, he's paying for it.
Because long time, 8 years ago, I got a big accident, almost dead. I'm a miracle. The doctor called me lucky boy. And every hospital that I go, everybody call me lucky boy. So I say, I don't go to saving any shit. I'm going to live in the life. This guy has a store. This store is really good, make a good money. Not to be rich, but make a good money to live in a good life. This guy don't go to nowhere. Nowhere. How many vacations you have? Last year when he went to Cuba, long time, a lot of time, but before that, he got the same prosperity, right? And he don't go to nowhere. One time in Puerto Rico, so his life, what he showed to his niece in Cuba, sending money every morning, 100, if you need this, I bring it to you, I send it to you. It's not the real life. When this girl, husband, and kid,
yeah, but it's not. But I used to
go
tell
to
them,
the real life,
I used to tell them,
they get fucked up.
No, but yeah. I used to tell them, you have to work. This is not a gift. I work for this.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. You gotta work.
Yeah, but his niece doesn't know that. And then when she sees the real life, she fucked up.
Yeah.
That's not what I come in.
Yeah.
Flaco, but I never.
She still wants it.
Flaco, but I never lied to her.
Yeah, you don't live. You don't. No, I don't
first
say
that. First thing I did when I went to Cuba, and you know that, she was a manicure. And she said, I wanted to go there. I said, listen, if you want to go there, you want to go with a good job and start making money, you got to stop that. You got to go to the cigar factory. She did it. She's a real Chino. She's a very good cigar roller. Her husband, they lied to me. I thought he was more of a hardworking guy, this and that. The guy doesn't want to work. But the only, look, you see what he tell you? You're the perfect sample. You know, you're already old timers. You got your money, you go here, you come back here. That's what I want to do when I get old. I don't want to be.
You're not old yet.
I don't want to have your age or your age and be tied up. I want to be able to get out, go to Starbucks. I don't care if the coffee's $20. I want to drive a car. I want to be a good car that I don't have to be calling no towing
right.
truck to. I want to be able to live. If I had lived all my life good, I want to be able to go the last year of my life living
good.
I want to be able to, if I keep smoking cigars and I don't have these anymore, to be able to do like you, come and buy a good cigar.
Yeah.
He's been in my house. You remember last time you were in my house? I rebuilt my house from scratch, right or wrong?
Yeah.
I like to live good. I put $40,000 in my house from one day to another. I ripped the bathroom up, I ripped the everything up, and I did it brand new. That's how I like to live. I like to go home and feel comfortable.
Yeah.
That's how I enjoy. I like, look what I drive. Beautiful brand new pickup truck. Since he knows me, this is the third pickup truck that you know me.
Brandy.
I change it every 2 years. I like to live. That's how everybody enjoys things. People enjoy drinking. I know that people enjoy smoking weed. I know that people enjoy doing coke. I like to enjoy. Like today, I told my wife, let's not cook. We bought food out. We ate it here. I don't enjoy going to the restaurant. Maybe I save $10 by not going to the restaurant. I like to buy food and eat it in my house.
Right.
Because I enjoy my house.
Right.
Because I rebuilt my house 4 years ago, and I put it the way that I wanted to enjoy. Now, I got a beautiful pool that I had never jumped in. It's another story. But inside my house, I enjoy my house.
Yeah.
Yes, but you work very hard for
you
that.
You work hard for it. That's
I enjoy
it.
My house. I like,
that's
so, you
thing.
See, that's what I like to do. He know. He sees me when I go out. I don't hesitate. And I pay. I spend the money. I like to. Everybody likes different things.
That's right.
He's always, like he always said, at the best place in Tampa Bay. But that's what he enjoys. And you know what? He doesn't drink. He goes to those places, but I enjoy all the things. Everybody enjoys.
That's right. Everybody's different.
You know, since a year ago, I had my mistress that I had for a lot of years that I was pretty much supporting her, and that's my life.
Yep.
I got cut off, my wife got me, big trouble, big problem. Everything, I stopped. So I like things that I do when I like it. I wanna have a $10,000 watch. I bought it. I bought one for my wife.
But you work for it.
I like to, you see, that's what motivate me. Now, me and my son got the Beamer. He got the 325. That's our gift. We're gonna get ourselves a 750 on December. Mm-hmm. That's our gift. We don't go for a big trip,
right?
But guess what? We're gonna be driving. My wife drives a Cadillac CTS.
I thought that's what she had.
But we're gonna give it to my youngest son. Because the car is paid before. So she's gonna drive it until December, and we're gonna. You see, that day is like me going to Hawaii. We're gonna go to the Beamer, to the ship, and we're gonna
get it right.
We wanted that one. That, you see, that's what we enjoy. Mm-hmm. So in our mind, we enjoy different things, but we enjoy things.
Yeah.
My wife, she came here. She ordered the food to be delivered at home. She brought it here. We sat down. He was working there. We ate it. Had two beers, and she was in her working clothes because she was going back home, cleaning all the, because we, that room is now is empty. So we have like a guest room that she wants to put it back in good shape again. So if you go home, have some.
So she came with dinner, went home to clean. Mm-hmm. When you get home, you go at 3 o'clock in the morning.
No, not today. Only from Monday to Friday.
I was gonna say, she goes with you to do that too?
No, from Monday to Friday. So now, somebody goes home, have a few drinks, and stay in that room until next day. And she's cleaning the room. She likes to have things clean.
Yeah.
So everybody enjoys different things. But what I enjoy is very healthy. I don't hurt nobody.
Yeah.
I don't hurt nobody what I enjoy. That's what we're talking about. We already said it. We got good credit. We got the money. We said it. For Christmas, we're going to pump ourselves. We're going to go get a 750.
Yeah.
And we're going to get it. And simple. You see? That's my goal. That's my Christmas vacation.
Yeah.
So now when I go working and my shoulder hurts, you know what I'm saying? That's my...
Uh-huh.
That's what it's going to take the pain away when I sit on my 750. So everybody got a different...
That's right. They do.
People enjoy different things. I enjoy what I enjoy.
Yeah. Next year, I'm going to be free. No, next year, no. In 2 years, I'll be free to go out of the country.
Really?
Yeah.
And where are you planning on going?
Oh!
Italy, Spain.
He likes a lot. Because he's a Bohemian guy. But not from now, from ever. He used to be a hippie. Long hair.
Really?
Shooting pills. Go out and sleep in funeral homes. He used to be a hippie. He likes a lot. Good for him. When he comes back, he's going to say, listen, I was in France. I was in this. And I'll tell him,
that was my dream.
And I'm going to tell him, buddy, the only thing that I did, I went back. I went to Miami on my 750. And it's nice, beautiful. So
everybody's
I don't
happy.
Like to drive a nice car.
You got a nice car.
You do?
Yeah, I got a nice car now. But I don't like to drive a nice car.
You know,
I want to go out of the country and see the world.
Yeah.
I want to go to China.
You do?
I see China movies. It's an amazing country. So I want to see by myself. I don't understand any fucking shit in Chinese. But I figured out how to do it.
Oh, no. There's always a way to communicate.
Yeah. But that's my dream. Travel the world.
Nothing wrong with that.
Nope.
2011, after I went to Cuba in 1 year, 4 times.
Wow.
I had my girlfriend there, but again, it almost cost me my divorce. and I have to stop. Plus, I spent $60,000.
Yeah.
So,
but that's what I say. You see, he don't lie to his niece. But what he talking and what she see, no make sense for her.
Mm-hmm.
So she came to this country with another idea.
Right.
Yeah, she saw, yeah, this is her idea. She was born in 1980-some.
Her uncle's going to take care of her. That's what she
came
she to
was
this
born,
with the
she
idea.
Was born in 1980-some. I was not even in Cuba at that time. She remembered growing up, seeing the guy every month taking the money for my mom, who's her, his, her grand, her grandmother. She remembered when she gave birth that I did all the baby shower from here for her kid. She know that I'd be supporting her. So, but I never lied to her. I swear to God on my kids. And
I know you don't lie.
I used to tell
no,
her.
No, you don't lie, but she thought, well, if I come here, it'll just continue.
I used to tell them, you got a very good age, you're still young. United States is not for old people. United States for young people, they can go work 20 years, 25 years, may do something. She knows that I've been upside down. She knows that I've been in prison because that was a big scandal in Cuba when my mom found out. She remembers seeing a picture of me in jail clothes. She remembers everything.
I remember you told us about that later.
She remembers everything, for God's sake. She knows that I got out in 1997, that I've been working full speed since 1997 to get what I got. She knew that the only thing that I had was a house when I got out. She knows everything. She knows my life because I used to tell her. Because she knew, because my wife had to tell my mom, hey, listen, your son is in jail. She knows, she remembers seeing my mom coming in 1991. She remembers seeing my mom coming back in 2001, 10 years later. She remembers everything. She's not dumb. So I never lied to her. She sees me every day because she's been living with me for 5.5 months. She sees me every day getting up and coming in and go here and go there. She saw me how I rebuilt this place in the landlord. I took $45,000 from the landlord to renew my 10-year lease. He wanted me here. He wanted me to stay here. So I took advantage of that. I said, you gotta give me money, you know. Otherwise, I'm out. I want to buy a piece of property for me. He lied to me. He told me like 8 years ago that he was going to sell me the unit. We even talked about $350,000. He never did. He said, oh, my father didn't love this person. So I told the guy, I'm out of here. I got another 4 months, but you got from me 2 months of rent because I gave it to you when I first moved in. So I'm going to pay you next and the other month, the other two, and I'm out. The guy says, I don't want you to leave here. You live there. So I said, you got to work out something for me. So I took $45,000 from the guy. I negotiated. Mm-hmm. I was going to pay this guy that he was going to charge me like $9,000 to do everything. I did my math. I said, I can do it for three. But it was hard working. You felt how many times you came here and I was working?
A lot of time.
So I did all the, I hired an electrician guy. I worked with an electrician guy. We paid, we make the humidor big. We got the granite, we bought the furniture, the TV, and I saved. But she saw me. She used to come here every day. She used to see me getting home full of pain.
Does she still roll cigars?
Yeah, of course. So she sees me. I haven't lied to her. In one bit, she sees, and I never lied to her. Super healthy. She looks like a Coca-Cola. Small, like in the top, you know, white eyes, like that. Super, super healthy. Never lie to her. Never lie to her.
She don't know anything.
How long have you known me from, Flaco?
A lot of years.
Have I ever lied to you? Have I ever lied to anybody? I don't lie to nobody. I'll tell you the way it is. So I never lied to her. She's a lazy, dirty, filthy girl.
That's.
You like that one?
Lazy.
Don't like it? But guess what? I'm happy. I got 1,800 square foot in my house with a beautiful 2-car garage, corner lot for myself. and me, my wife, and my old, youngest kid.
How old's your youngest?
Well, my youngest is the size of him. My youngest is gonna be 18 next month. But my pride is the other one. Ask him, sharp, good-looking kid, dresses. How did he dress, Flaco? Tell him how he dresses. He dresses in suits. I give him, I bought him gold bracelet, this, and these. He got a nice watch. He dresses nice, and he looks good. And I told him, you gotta, now I'm talking to him. I said, I'm gonna help you out. I want you to go back and get your master's.
Master's. What is his degree in?
He got 2 degrees.
Okay.
One in international business.
Okay.
And another one is, I think, business and management or something.
Wow.
So
2 degrees in 4 years, he worked full time.
And he worked full time. Not only that, he graduated December the 13th, and he was hired January the 3rd. Because he, while he was working to college, he used to work for this girl. And she said, you're sharp, you already got a lot of experience. Once you graduate, I have a guy that's gonna hire you. He travels, he has a credit card from the company. They give him, he makes like $50. They give him like $250 a month, car allowances. They give him a credit card. He brings the customers here to meetings. They drink, they smoke. Never charge him, of course. But if you always want me to charge him, he can take customers to eat. He go to Dallas, he go to here. So he lives life the way he wants it. But now his company is talking about give him money or help him pay for his master's. And I said, I'll put the other money.
Good.
I said, I'll put the other, you know, you're gonna do it for, I mean, it's gonna cost you a dollar. And he says, yeah. He says, done this year, because he just finished.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a year in December that he finished. He's only 24. He says, let me take this year off, and next year, I'm gonna go back. I said, go back, I'm gonna help you out.
Good.
That's good.
Wow. You did something right.
Well, remember the old saying, you can take the horse to the river.
Yeah, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink.
So I did my part. He saw me, and he
saw
his
mom. You were a good example.
Clean people, clean hounds, working people, and everything. And he took the right boss, and he did it. He made it. He knows that whatever he needs, I'm almost gonna be there. But this kid, this young girl. What a disgrace.
Yeah,
and I don't want to tell my mom, and I don't want to tell my sister, because my sister is her mom.
Yeah.
And I don't want to. Now I'm paying now for the last 6 months, paying my sister to fix the house. And all that house that was hers, then when she left, I moved my sister in there. And she said, no, I did this and that and that. So now my sister's doing this and doing that. And showing me pictures, so now I'm like, you never did anything. But I don't wanna create problems. My niece, she doesn't get along with my mom. And my mom was the one who raised her.
Yeah.
But I don't wanna say nothing. But today I'll be able to be on the wheels, watching TV in the living room. Because I got my wife and my son. Before, I couldn't.
Yeah.
She's my niece by blood, but we don't have no relation. I mean, I met her in 2010, and I brought her here. So, my wife today can be in her funny, you know, women put funny clothes.
Uh-huh.
Because she doesn't have to be in front of her husband. So we got a good freedom today in English. We got my house, we got a nice freedom. Sunday, today, Saturday. Tomorrow we get up in the morning. My wife and I, we make grits. We make omelet. We sit by the pool. And we eat. My son.
You like grits?
My son loves grits, and I love grits. I'm an American when it comes to grits.
I was gonna say that doesn't sound like it.
No, not only that. You want to eat me good? You want to see me eating good? Grits and fish.
Yeah.
I love it.
Oh.
Or grits and fried chicken. I love it too.
Oh.
A hot sauce.
Okay.
Oh, I can eat grits every day. I love it. And my wife makes it. Real, you see, we like that. We like to get up at 12 o'clock. We got a machine. Then we put all kinds of apples in it.
Yeah.
We like to do that. We like to do toast. And then we do the grits. And then at nighttime, like last Sunday, we went to a good restaurant, Mexican restaurant that my son went before. He took some customers. It's called Miguel. We went to that one. So tomorrow we eat a good breakfast about 12 o'clock, and by 8 o'clock we go out to eat. I told my son, let's meet out back, let's meet over here, we all eat. And that's it, that's what we do on Sunday. We get a good breakfast at the house, comfortable.
Yep.
Then we light up a cigar after we see the dogs running in the grass. Mm-hmm. And then everybody go their way. And then we meet back at 8 o'clock in my house. And we go eat here, there, anywhere. I enjoy that.
Yeah, that's nice.
It is. That's why you work hard, mm-hmm. so you can enjoy all that.
And Monday, if you are awake Monday about 12 o'clock, you're going to say, Ulysses at church.
That's where you'll be, Monday morning.
I told my wife I'm going to buy a skating.
There you go.
Because it's too long. But I'm an animal working. I'm an animal. But I enjoy that. And not only that, I have to do it out of a moral thing. To teach her and to teach her husband that it was not about me. It's about making it. So I'm gonna do it for months and months and months. Maybe I'm gonna do it for a year before we get somebody to do it. So, cause I wanna come back in 6-7 months and say, look, I'm here and I don't have no knee. Cause believe me, I don't have no knee.
Yeah.
And I'm doing it. And you said, that was your extra money.
Yeah.
She's my family. I was working around her time here so she can do that. So she was, you know, family thing. But I'm gonna do it.
Yeah, and sometimes, like you found out, it doesn't work with family.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna teach it that it can be done.
Yeah. Are you gonna get your cigars, Geary?
Yeah.
And get yourself a lighter too, please. Mm-hmm. One that works.
I'm gonna get some of these cigars. I like these.
Very nice.
Yeah, it's lasts a long time too.
Yeah, I noticed first. It's not a real long cigar, a big cigar.
But you know why it's not? Because it's packed well.
Tight, yeah.
Yeah.
It's packed well. There's a lot of tobacco in there. So, yeah.
He enjoys this.
Mm-hmm.
We came out of the restaurant. He said, do you want to go? And I said, yeah.
What do you eat?
He never even finished what he was saying.
What do you eat?
Over the city
fish. Yeah, city fish.
What do you eat?
I had oysters. I love oysters.
Raw.
Nice. Yeah.
They have
the best oysters.
If one day you're going to get full of oysters, that you don't want to eat no more oysters.
I don't get them that often to get full.
As good as that, and cheap. Very inexpensive. You know where, Flaco? Ryan's by the river in Tampa.
Oh, yeah.
The good thing about it, excellent. My wife loves. I get burns, and I lobster. I burn this. Because I eat so much and I eat out of the.
Oh, yeah.
So I get burned here.
Yeah.
But I probably eat probably 3-4 dozen. My wife prefers some lemon, this and that, and then I go one by one. And beer.
Absolutely.
You gotta have beer with love.
You gotta have, yep.
You're never gonna drink nothing else than beer.
Nope. I'm with you.
Cold beer.
Yep.
Maybe tomorrow I go eat. maybe I go eat tomorrow oysters.
I love sushi.
You love sushi?
Yeah, we love our sushi.
Don't know. He tried it for the people that were sitting next to us he was talking with, and she ordered 2 big plates of sushi. Mm-hmm. Sushi. She said, when I came in, I was really hungry. She can't finish it all. But they were chatting about it, and she gave him a taste.
Look.
So now he's going to try it.
Look, let me tell you something. One day that you got to make do it like I do it. One day I don't eat that much at night time. Got to be on a Saturday and Sunday. The best brunch ever is in Cinefish. You can go eat as much sushi as you want. They got crab leg, mimosa.
How much you pay for the brunch over there?
It's about $28 per person. But let me tell you something. The best $28 you can go. As soon
I heard that from somebody else.
As soon as you're going, look, mimosa, one after the other one. You go, you got a hot thing that you can eat eggs, this and that. But then you got sushi, crabs. You got all that, which that's what I go for.
Yes.
I'm not going to go to a restaurant and eat eggs and...
No, I'm not going to do that.
The other day I went to the Cottonwood.
Mm-hmm.
A nice place, good place. I get a combo sushi sashimi. Oh my goodness, a plate like that. Oh,
really?
Yeah.
You don't look like you could eat that much.
Oh,
yeah.
He's a pig. He can eat more than me. You know what happened to that guy? That guy was going to Miami, and he fell asleep behind the wheel. And he started flipping, nine flips, and they found him dead. But look at this, he was driving by himself. He got lucky, he came out of the coma. Next day. But look at this, 2 months ago, he goes back to the doctor. The doctor wanted to see him. And he told, it was a girl, a guy. He told a friend of his, hey, take me to the doctor. I want him to check me out. Well, when the girl was driving, she flipped too.
I did have to.
So when we went to North Carolina, you know what I said to him? Don't even look over here. You sit over there. Don't even touch the steering wheel.
Can you imagine that?
You flip.
He did have flip then.
Yeah, but she flipped upside down. She stayed upside down. Well, can you imagine that? He goes back to the doctor. And the car where he's driving, a girl is driving, that hand flips and stays with his four tires off.
I have to call the doctor and say, hey, I need to change the appointment. What happened? I got another accident.
Oh, my God.
Can you imagine that?
No.
But he just got an accident about 3 months ago. He hit somebody, that person hit somebody, and another person. He was like hitting, ging, 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 ging.
Don't ever take him anywhere.
Crazy?
No,
I don't let him, we had gone to Miami a few times.
I can't.
You know what I tell him?
Don't look over here. Look at this, I went in the red light. Everybody stopped in the red light. They put the green light. It's not a big traffic at this time. And the car in front of me stopped like nothing. At this time, I'm driving the transportation. My brake is not, they are long to brake. As soon as I came out to the green light, it got stopped, and I'm, oh shit! But my car keep going, and I hit it then.
Pow! And the car hit another car. Pow!
The asshole in front of me who stopped like that, I think he was talking on the phone. He didn't even saw me when I go over him. So I hit him, and he hit another person. Bang!
No. One day we have to call the police to make a report. He's driving a rental car, and he comes here, and he bam!
No, that was, I get mad with somebody, and I was driving on backward, on forward.
I got you.
So the guy next to me has a post mail, where you put the letters?
Mailbox.
The mailbox in the house is still. And I was driving, I'm not really good driving because I never had a car in Cuba. So I was driving, I was straight to the fucking shed. So I'm scratching the car from here to here. So at the end, I got a big hole.
No, he's very, well, we had gone.
So I came here and I called the police. Hey, when I'm going out, I saw my car scratch. So they give me a police report.
I knew what we were going to do.
We went to North Carolina together. 10 hours drive. He even touched the steering wheel. I drove back. I, drove that way, and I drove back.
Well, that was probably a smart thing.
Of course, I would never be in the car lane drive. Can you imagine flip, go back and flip again?
Yeah, no.
You don't flip. I've been driving for 32 years. I have never, I mean, that's something that not everybody can do.
No, that's true.
Flip? He has a big operation. You have it because he got hair. He has one from here.
Because I got a big here.
Yeah.
It's the one that's supposed to be in coma. But this eye, the arteria, make it together with the beam. So my blood was straight to my eye. So I got my eye. After I get out of the hospital, my eyes start grow up, like a ping pong ball. So when I went to the doctor, everybody told me, you look good. But I know that something was wrong. So as soon as the doctor see me, he took me to the room. It was like 20 more doctors around me. And everybody with that shit that you put over here, he put on my eyes and I got something on my eye. Tum, 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 tum. So he sent me to Fort Myers, to the best optical
neurosurgeon
on the United States.
They open 3 years. Look, they open.
The next day they open
surgery to the side
here.
Can you imagine?
Up to here.
From here
to drain.
Really?
Yeah, to drain all the blood.
From here.
Yeah.
Yeah, he can open here on my head. So he came through here,
right.
Drain all the blood, and then separate the arteria with the vein.
Huh?
I was 15 days again in the hospital.
50 years ago, they would have taken his eye.
No wonder you don't like going to doctors.
I don't go to the doctor. I never see.
You've seen enough.
I never been sick.
Yeah.
I got 9 years.
You just hurt yourself.
I got 9 years in this country. You see me? I never sick. I always good. The day I'm going to die, I'm going to die like that. Boom. Why he died? Cancer, this and that. But boom. Because I don't feel nothing. Listen, I do fans. I'm installing fans. Everybody who work with me, they got day off because he's sick for this. A young guy, 20-some year old, he got a problem on his knees. Another 20-some year guy already used glasses. I'm 43 year old, I'm going every day to work.
Even after everything you've been through.
You know how they call me over there? Smiley. Because I always like that. They never give me mad. They never see me mad.
Yeah.
I was happy.
Yeah.
And they asking me.
Cuban, you're going to get two kinds of Cuban. The lazy guys and the one that works for the lazy one. There's no in between.
Listen, my friend asking me, bro, do you have problem in your life? Yeah, I got a lot. But you never mad. You never sad. You always happy. My friend, listen.
Mm.
I leave my problem in a basket of my house. I don't charge with me over here.
Nope.
Because let me ask you, if you got a problem and you don't have a solution for that problem, whatever you do, you don't have the solution, what do you make with this problem with you thinking about it? You get a stressing. Mm-hmm. Right?
Right.
So I leave it on my house. When I got the solution, I take the problem and I solve. I get a ticket. I was to the clinic take it off the point. I go to the class. The guy start asking everybody what get the ticket. No, I'm going to hurry, this and that. I got this problem in my mind, da 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 da. When he gets to me, he asking me, whoa, why you get the ticket? Because I like running. I like the speeding. I like the speeding. But you are in a hurry, you're stressing.
Yeah.
You're stressing. My friend, in my life, I don't know what means that. I never get stressed. My life is a whole happiness life. I always happy. I don't know what means stress. I heard people talk about, I'm stressing. I don't know what is that shit.
Well, that's
I really don't know. I don't know what is that. I always smile. I say to people, my friend, I got an accident 8 years ago. I was supposed to be in coma for the rest of my life. Maybe like a vegetable. And next day I wake up, fighting with the nursing. Hey, take me all that shit on me and ready to go home.
What?
Yeah, I had a lot of things to do. And the nursing was fighting with me. No, you can, yeah, I can, take it off. At this time, a doctor came in and said, what happened here? Nothing, my friend, I'm ready to go home. But you know where you are. I'm in the hospital. And you know what happened to you? I got an accident. But I'm good. Listen, look. I'm ready to go home. You are a fucking lucky boy. Not only that, when I go to pick stuff on my car, I went to the place, I got a tag.
What do you mean?
Over here.
Pick out some cigars.
So I went to the place to pick stuff on my car.
Yeah.
And a guy sent me, take me to there.
Yeah, and he went to the pound where they took the car. To pick up things in his tag.
Right.
Few things, so the guy
who bring the car say to my friend, I'm really sorry for your friend or family who died there. The guy say, nobody did there. Really? But what is him? You see the one with the pad? That's the guy.
You said you had a patch on your
eye. That's the guy. The guy was there walking through me, say, my friend, you're a lucky boy. He sent me the same shit to the doctor.
You know who found him? A ranger, 3 o'clock in the morning, is going down.
Really?
And he sees a car underneath, upside down, with the lights on. Who found him.
That's how they found
him. He's not like somebody called. He was left for dead until somebody saw him.
Wow.
Tiene algo porque la mojamos, mira la fuerza. Pero si mira, si tú lo tienes que mirar ahora, si la dejas un ratito abierta así, se seca. Pero está bien. Ahora, aquí a mañana, cuando tú le vuelvas a dar la prensita, ya se hace un tubito. Yo creo que ella era lo que ella era en lo que ella fue toda su vida. Mira la cara, ¿qué tú crees que puede tener cara? Jueza.
Jueza.
She was the judge. Huh?
When he looked. When he looked at me, I thought, okay, what are you saying?
I said, what do you think she used to do for a living?
He said, I don't know.
No, because you got
her. Almost go to jail.
But you have that face.
Do it.
Yeah, George has a
face. You know that
Omar? I have a face.
George has some.
You know that Omar almost go to jail. With the judge.
Huh?
Yeah, I almost go to jail.
Yeah, he's fighting the custody for his daughter, so, you know.
And my ex-wife trying to put me like a piece of shit, I was counting to 10.
So he's floating.
When I get fucked up, I say to the judge, I say, you know what? Let me tell you something. This woman over here is a fucking liar. But not only that,
whoops,
he's a fucking bitch.
I saw the guy, you know, the judge said, look at this, he's crazy. And the judge said, hey, what? You know, a big commotion, people start coming in. Go ahead. So yeah, the judge said, listen, you gotta apologize to the people here. You gotta apologize to me.
It's a woman. What's a woman?
You gotta apologize to her. So he got up and he says, I'm sorry.
Yes. But you know what? At the end of everything, I get everything what I want.
Good.
Tell
the truth.
And when we go, she gave me a weekend with my daughters. After I have like a year without see her. When I came back to the court again, this woman, even she gave mad with me for what I did, this woman gave me a hug. Said, you're a really good father.
Aw, see?
So I got everything what I want.
Yeah, I can get it.
Because I'm doing good. You're trying to put me like a piece of shit, but it's not like that. So I sent a fucking course. This woman is a fucking bitch. She's a fucking liar. And I don't like to start a conversation.
All right.
Because I get mad and start screaming. So, like three people, like three officers go inside the room and say,
yeah.
The lady say, hold on. So they came out, and when I done, he say, you have to apologize with her and with me. This up. I feel really bad. So I say, okay, I'm sorry.
Can you imagine?
Oh yeah, I can.
Look, this lighter is a non-stop thing. Watch this.
You think you want more flame? Let's go like that. Go like that. Because if you want more flame, you got here plus and a minus. You go plus. Okay. Let me put that up for you.
He might burn his nose off.
He's funny, huh? Funny guy.
Yeah.
He knows me because I don't got too many friends because I say too many truth.
That's right.
So that's what I did in the court.
Cool.
I say only the truth.
Okay.
So I don't got too many friends.
People don't like to hear the truth.
My girlfriend told me, you're always talking shit about me. I don't talk shit about you. I've told you the truth on your face. And you don't ready to hear the truth.
When they come here together, they always leave fighting.
Because
I put them to fight.
Oh, you're a nice guy, y'all.
I just told you the truth. Listen, I met that girl for about 3 years we got in a relationship. I pushed her like a kid to go to school. And she don't finish yet.
Oh, jeez.
And then when I say the truth, you always talking shit about me. I never said that in my life. I don't talking shit about you. I told you the truth. You don't ready to hear the truth, let me know, and then I go out, and you go by yourself.
You need a receipt?
Because it's like that. Truth make you free.
That's right, it does.
You want to be free, say the truth.
You're
listen,
right.
I pay my car, I don't ask him money to nobody. I pay my bills, I don't ask him money to nobody. So I don't have to be hypocrite.
You're welcome.
That's right.
I say the truth. The lady in the court, give me a hope at the end. Because I say the truth. When she talked to my, when we came back, the first thing was talk to my daughter without us.
Can I take a shot?
Yep.
So, came the mother. I don't know what she said to the mother. Came in, she get up.
We're here. Hey, while you're here, if you need anything, let me know.
I will.
She get up and give me a hug.
Okay.
I don't work. I mean, we open tomorrow. I'm always here from Monday to Saturday. We open tomorrow. I don't have to be here tomorrow, but tomorrow I'm going to be the whole day because I'm making extra room to put all our merchandise. So I'll be here tomorrow in and out. Hope the store is open.
On the child support call, that was a family case. On the child support call, was the same thing. They give me $400, $29, $420 with 84 cents for child support, $2. The judge asking me, that was a man. You see your daughters? No. Why you don't see your daughters? You have to ask her. So, I was to the child support with the translator, but I can say in English. When he told me, why you don't see your daughter? I had to say in Spanish, and then the translator said to him in English. So I say in English to him, you have to ask her, he told me. You got a translator speaking Spanish. Okay. So she said. Or at the end of the case, she asked it to my ex-wife, do you have any questions, something to say? She was going to say why she don't allow me to see my daughters. When she started talking and the translator started talking to her, you know what said the judge? This is not a family case. This is child support. You do this in a family case. So he asking me thing out of the child support. And he allowed me to say, but she don't allow to him say. Because I was saying the truth. Why you don't see your daughter? Asking to her.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What's behind you, honey?
So that's why people don't like me too much. Because wherever I go, this is like that. If you don't like it, it's your problem. But it's like that.
I don't know.
You relax tomorrow.
All right, I will.
It's nice talking with you.
All right, we
will.
Huh?
Well, how do you say your name?
No, Flaco. Flaco means a skinny guy.
Oh, skinny guy.
My name is another story. My name is Javier. Lorenzo. But my dream in this country is becoming a citizen and translate my name is, put my name in English.
So when he became American citizen?
When I became a citizen, I called Xavier.
Well,
and I don't allow nobody to call me Javier.
No more.
Xavier.
Or Flaco.
Or Flaco. Everybody call me Flaco.
Okay.
But I'm Xavier.
I'm a mannequin, citizen. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
You guys take care.
We'll see you again.
I'm an American citizen.
Ella
está, ella tiene un billete,
ella tiene un billete. ¿Qué sabía que no me da la venga?
Bah, ya
te encantaba oír. Tiene las piernas de la mamá. Ella fue jueza toda la vida. Ella que había sido judge.